Well, hello YouTubers and my friends. Today, once again, after 5 years, I have got the opportunity to talk about one very coveted, very famous and one of the most rare HMT watches. And today I will give you a complete review of this particular HMT Roman chronograph. I have bought this watch in 2015 and now after use of 4.5 years, I am again going to speak about this watch. That time I made a small unboxing and introduction. Today I am going to give you a complete insight of this watch. Though it is a quartz watch, so I do not expect many watch enthusiasts to, you know, focus on this actually. But this review is specially for all the HMT watch enthusiasts and all the chronograph lovers equally. So let's go with the specifications. The case dia here is 39 mm, the lug size is 18 mm, and it has chronograph function with 3 registers, one at 6 o'clock, that is the seconds hand that works normally in normal operation of a watch. Then we have the 12 hours counter, then we have an 1 hour counter or 60 minutes register at 12 o'clock. It has a date feature, and the series of the watch Roman, HMT and chronograph is mentioned at 3 o'clock. So as I have extensively used this watch, so there are signs of wear, but I really love this watch in this state. The crown has a jewel embossed here, and the chronograph function pushers at 2 o'clock and the other at 4 o'clock. So notice how 4 has been written with 4-. That is, I think, one of the rules in the, you know, watchmaking, that nobody will write 4 as the actual Roman 4, but 4- instead. So that is a cool thing to look here. And the strap is a very nice crocodile strap, and that came with this watch. And I think this is the signature of the Roman series of watches. There are other Roman series of watches also, but not all of them are chronographs. This is the only one that I have here. So if you see here, it is mentioned here India and RGGL01A, that is the model number of this watch. So the Roman chronograph has the reference of RGGL01A. So I think this is the only code that you can use to look up in the HMT catalog regarding the prices and specifications and all. The lug is very unique, and it is in two parts. So one is attached to the case and another is attached to the strap, so it gives it a very vintage look. And I think this entire chronograph design is very similar to IWC Da Vinci chronograph. So I really like the overall appeal of this chrono. So if you can see the strap here, so I will show you 2 to 3 things. That it was mentioned here, Roman in golden, that has faded due to time. So you see the Roman mentioned here, and here it was HMT embossed. So in the case back, you can see HMT logo, if you can look it clearly. Yeah, it is water resistant with stainless steel case back, and the code is written 421005, and it has OS10 Miota quartz movement. And that is a chronograph movement, and the model mentioned here is RGGL01. So the Miota OS10 or 0S10, whatever people like to call it, are very reliable and within budget chronograph movements that I think they are used in almost many quartz chronograph watches. So these movements are really a workhorse. So this watch has been with me since 4.5 years. I never had any jamming complaint or anything in this particular watch, except that the battery drains faster comparatively to other quartz watches. So I think I had a change of battery like almost 3 times in this watch till now. So it uses a series 927 button cell. So yeah, any standard 927 series button cell will work. So that is a really good thing that you get that battery in the market. So the hands are blued here. That is a painted blue. Theirs are not burnt blue. and it gives a really a nice vintage feeling to this watch. So I really like this watch overall, and I think, yeah, I am the lucky one to have this watch because I have seen it appear only once in the genuine HMT website, and I think very few people have them. I can hardly remember only 5 to 10 people having them in our HMT group and HMT people who collect the HMT watches. So I have seen only 5 to 10 people having this watch. There may be others also, but I don't think they have posted any pics on internet before. So I was really in love for with this watch. I mean, yeah, I wanted to collect this watch for a very long time, but I have been lucky in 2015 itself. So I really got a good discount on this watch. So let me show you how the chronograph works here. So now it is working in a normal mode. So now the time is 12 o'clock in the afternoon. So I will just press the pusher once. So you see the chrono function has started here. This is a quartz chronograph. In my earlier videos, I have shown you two mechanical chronographs. So let me stop it at 15. And it has stopped. Now, in order to reset the chronograph, pay attention that I have to press this reset button and it has come back to 12 o'clock position. Now, I will tell you one more interesting fact about the Miyota 0S10 movement, that there might be an offset during the reset of the chronograph. It may stop at 11, it may stop at some seconds behind 12 o'clock or some seconds before 12 o'clock, after 12 o'clock. So, how to take care of that? See, this is not the movement jamming or there is any problem with the movement. This is just a calibration problem that arises in any electronic equipment that is used over time. So the Miyota 0S10 datasheet and operations manual have this recalibration technique where you pull the crown to the second place, not in the first place, to the second place, and then consecutively push the reset button and then the start button. So it will increment and come back, or decrement and come back to its original 12 o'clock position, and that is the calibration function. So if this kind of trouble is happening with your Roman chrono or any 0S10 chronograph, then know that it is not a mechanical error, it is just a calibration error, and that can be easily taken care of. So this particular watch has this function because earlier I faced the trouble, but after I read the online data sheet, it was totally normal. So the watch is again, you know, bouncing back to its original condition. And I think after several years of use, I will now polish the case because I have some dirt sitting in the lug corners and etc. So yeah, I would never let this watch go. And I think this is one of the best watch that I have. I mean, let it be quartz, but from HMT, I mean, being an HMT watch collector, I really love this. So here is the total detailed review of this watch. Thank you for watching the video. Do like, share and subscribe. And this was the HMT Roman chronograph RGGL001. So yeah, just take a look. Take a look at this beauty. I mean, I do not want to stop the review. I can go long talking and talking, but yeah, I have to make other videos as well. So thanks for watching. Have a good day. Bye.